1X just released its newest Neo Humanoid for $500 a month, so I'm going to take a closer look at some of the stats that no one's talking about that may give Neo several advantages people aren't expecting. Starting out with its self-charging battery. This apparently takes 6 minutes per hour of charge, 842 watt hours in the battery, although it's not hot swappable. The robot here is doing these house tasks using the Redwood Vision Language Action World model, powered by the NVIDIA Jetson Thor, that's on board with 2070 tera operations per second of AI compute, allowing it to do these tasks. Also, you can see it's teleoperated, comes with an app, so hopefully you'll also be able to use the first person view to control it. Then when it comes to the hands, 22 degrees of freedom in each of them, and all throughout the robot, 75 degrees of freedom. It's using this special polymer for no pinch points. This allows for the robot to really be extremely safe inside of the home. One question would be, is this material flammable or not? When it comes to the robot's movement speeds, quite fast. Actually, it can walk at 1.4 meters per second or run at 6.2 meters per second. 22 decibels of sound through its three speakers in its pelvis and chest. Then coming to its cortex-based system here, this is the brain of the robot powering the entire system. Two RGB cameras in the entire robot. This is the emotive light that tells you different things, like, for instance, probably the battery charge, among others. Here are some of the stats. Four microphones, 154 pounds of lifting capacity, 55 pounds of carrying capacity. And when it comes to the robot inside of the home, it has a companion aspect to it as well. It takes natural language as its primary input. So it's built to be able to not only just do house tasks like you're seeing here, but also interact with humans. It also can observe its environment and do chores. Just with natural language, you can tell it, go do this, and it does a long horizon task. Here's the carrying case of the entire robot. And one thing, you can see him turning on the robot there, no hot swappable battery. I'll get into this in just a second, but there are some stats that nobody has talked about that could, in the next version, be quite an improvement. Here, this gentleman is looking, making eye contact. Also, this woman, you can see her move away very quickly, and the robot follows. And when it comes to the software running, the robot is able to learn in real time as well as upgrade over the air, hopefully to do some of these chores. Here's the mobile application, and you can set up when you want it to do different chores. One thing that would be very helpful is, can you use the first-person perspective to control basically a teleoperated home robot to talk to it, tell it what to do? Here it's doing some of these tasks like tidying the living room, potentially doing laundry, but it would be nice if you could see this in the app and talk to it in real time. For instance, go open the door, move the shoes here, put this there. This is something that hasn't yet been mentioned, but looking at this robot, so tell me in the comments if you know any more about how this app actually works, if you can talk to the robot as you watch its first person perspective. And these robots are expected to be able to teach each other over the air. So one robot's experience is actually teaching the Redwood world model along the way so that other robots can learn in lockstep in real time. And so this is quite an impressive level of dexterity. Look at the hand. Also, something that we're going to show you in just a second, waterproof and splash proof here. This is something with other robots that we haven't yet seen. Also, the hands with these 22 degrees of freedom, they look like they have some rubbery type of an outer layer here for extra grip. And this is the emotive gear that tells the user the state of the robot, whether it needs a charge. And here it is talking to a user.
I can't seem to find my glasses. Is this paprika?
No, that's cayenne pepper. Also, your glasses are on your shirt.
Could I use this in my chili?
They're both made from chili peppers, and you could put cayenne in your chili, but it is much spicier.
Now, the robot is interacting with different participants here using its reinforcement learning. Now, you can see another interaction here walking around the house. It's able to talk with natural language. Now here Neo is having another conversation. It would be interesting to know how many languages are currently supported in the natural language interface of this robot. You can see it's observing its environment here with its two 8.85 megapixel RGB cameras that are built in. And this is all running on board the Jetson Thor. And when it comes to the whole body is covered in this 3D lattice polymer. Now let's get into some of the stats. 66 pounds for this robot, 18 pounds per arm in terms of its payload. And altogether, that's a 55 pound carrying capacity. Here you can see that the user told the robot to go open the door for his friend. This is just with natural language. You order it to walk around, do this and that. Hand speed, very fast. Look at how dexterous it is. 8 meters per second of hand speed. And the hands look quite large. Look at the size of those. They actually look to be different than the hands in the beginning of the video. I don't know if there's some type of a glove. Maybe that is part of the water resistance. But you can see here that the hand is actually exposed with its knuckles. There's not supposed to be any pinch points on the robot. So I would assume that even without the gloves, these knuckles are not really large enough to catch any skin. And you can see the robot folding the laundry, very fast movements with all 75 degrees of freedom throughout its body. Now, here's something that no one is actually talking about. If you do the math, this is selling for $20,000 outright, $500 per month plan. But what does it cost to hire an employee, a basic level employee, probably $2,000 a month? That means that this is running at about 25% of the cost of your average worker. So in terms of a service industry job, maybe McDonald's, for instance, you could be saving potentially $1,500 to $2,000 per month by running this robot. And when it comes to the power, remember it runs for 4 hours and 6 minutes of charge equals each hour of usage. So that equals out to just under 22 hours per day of use. And something that they haven't done yet that could optimize by over 10% would be to just make a hot swappable battery. So it's very likely that they'll be upgrading this battery to be hot swappable to get that extra roughly 2 hours of work time in there. This means that businesses using Neo at a $500 a month subscription rate would only be spending 1/4 to 1/8 of what they would be spending on a human worker. But let's take a look at the website here because this robot is already selling. You see $499 per month for the subscription and $20,000 to purchase it outright. Comes with a 3-year warranty and premium support. Currently 3 colors. We have this cream color and a bluish gray color and black. And they're taking these early $200 deposits. People on Twitter are already purchasing these, but when we look at the frequently asked questions, it would be interesting to know if you purchase the robot for $20,000, is there some type of an insurance policy beyond that 3-year warranty? And let's check out maintenance. It says that 1X service can provide mobile support for every Neo robot, but what happens if there's an actual mechanical problem? That'd be interesting to know. Tell me in the comments if you know any more about that. And here's the $64 million question everybody's been asking about data collection. Looks like Neo is collecting the data to use it, but they're not building a profile for you. But tell me, would you trust this robot operating inside of your house? And who is responsible if this robot makes a mistake and, say, burns down the house, for instance? Tell me in the comments what you think and check out this video here comparing the Figure 3 robot to the Optimus 2.5.